Hello guys, my name is Ashish and welcome to the Java tutorial series. In the previous tutorial we have discussed about the data types in Java in detail. Today in this tutorial we are going to discuss about the keywords or the reserved words in Java. So guys, if you have not subscribed the channel, I will request you to please subscribe the channel to get notification whenever a new tutorial is uploaded in this channel. So let's start. Keywords or the reserved words in Java. Keywords or the reserved words are the words in Java language that are used for some internal process, and keywords represent some predefined task which cannot be changed in further. So keywords represent some predefined task by the JVM and it cannot be changed in further. We cannot use these keywords for the use of variable name or the object. So guys, this is very important. We cannot use these keywords name as a variable name or as an object, right guys? Okay, now next, the doing this will result in compile time error. We will get a compile time error if we define the keywords as an variable or an object. So next, so the next is the list of the keywords I have arranged for you guys, and they are as listed below, like abstract keyword. This abstract keyword is used to declare abstract class. Abstract class can provide the implementation of interface. It can have abstract and non-abstract methods. Right guys, abstract class is used to define an abstract class. Now next, the boolean keyword. This boolean keyword is used to declare a variable as a boolean type. We can assign or it can store true or false values only. Boolean variables can store only true and false variable. It cannot store int, string type, character type variables, right guys? Now byte. Byte keyword is used to declare a variable that can hold an 8-bit of data values. It can only hold till 8-bit data values. Case. This case keyword is used with the switch statement as condition check. Now catch. This catch keyword is used to catch the exception generated by try statements. This should be used after a try block only. Catch keyword can only be used after the try block only. Now care. The care keyword is used to declare a variable that can store unsigned 16-bit Unicode characters. Right? It can store only unsigned data of 16-bit Unicode characters. Right? Now the next is class. This class keyword is used to declare a class. We can use this class keyword as to declare any class. Continue keyword. Java continue keyword is used to continue the loop. It continues the character flow of program and skips the remaining code as a specified condition. So now next, in the next slide we are going to see the default keyword. This default keyword is used to run the default block of a code inside a switch statement. Inside the switch statement we have the different cases, and in the last we use default. So this default keyword is used to run the default block of the code inside a switch statement. Do keyword. Java do keyword is used in control statement to declare a loop. Double. This double keyword is used to declare a variable that can hold 64-bit floating point number. So double keyword will hold only 64-bit floating points number. Else keyword. Java else keyword is used to run the alternative block in an if statement. If the if condition is not satisfied inside the if condition in any program, then the else condition will run. So here the else keyword is used to run the else part of the program. Enum. This enum keyword is used to define a fixed set of constant. Enum constructors are always private or default. So this is very important guys. Enum constructors are always private or default. Now extend. Java extend keyword is used to indicate that a class is derived from another class or interface. Actually extend keyword is used in the concept of inheritance of the OOPs. So next is final. Java final keyword is used to indicate that a variable holds a constant value. It is applied with a variable. Java variable value cannot be changed further in a program. So next is finally. Java finally keyword is used as a block of code in a try-catch structure. This block is always executed whether exception is handled or not. So guys, this is very important point that this block is always executed whether the exception is handled or not. Finally block cannot be ignored. So right inside after the try and catch structure we write the finally block, and the finally block will always be executed. Actually inside the finally block we generally write the close connections of the any. Okay guys, so the next is finally. So finally we have done. Now the next is float. Java float keyword is used to declare a variable that can hold a 32 bit floating point number. So float variable will hold 32 bit of floating point number. For keyword, Java for keyword is used to start a for loop. It is used to execute a set of instructions functions repeatedly when some condition become true. If the number of iteration is fixed, it is recommended to use a for loop. So guys, where we can use for loop? If the number of iteration is fixed, as we know the number of iteration, then we can go for loop. So next keyword is if. Java if keyword test the condition. It execute the if block if condition is true. So generally if is used to execute any block if the condition is true, right? Now the next is implement. Java implements keyword is used to implement an interface. Now next is import. Java import keyword makes classes and interface available and accessible to the current source code. Import keyword is used to import any Java class or any source code inside a class. Instance of. Java instance of keyword is used to test whether the object is an instance of a specified class or implements an interface. So instance of is used to check that it is whether the object of any specified class or an interface, right? Now the int. Int keyword is used to declare a variable that can hold up to a 32 bit signed integer. Int type variable only can hold up to 32 bit signed integer. Interface. Java interface keyword is used to declare an interface. It contains only abstract method, right? So if we have to declare any interface, then we are going to use interface keyword here. And interface contains only abstract method. Okay guys, now the next keyword is long. This long keyword is used to declare a variable that can hold up to 34 bit integer, right? Now native. Java native keyword is used to specify that a method is implemented in a native code using JNI. That means Java native interface. Next is new keyword. Java new keyword is used to create new object. If we have to create any object of a class, then we are going to use the new keyword, right? Class, if there is a class with a name hello, then we are going to like hello h1 equals to new hello. Here the new keyword is used to create the object of a hello class. Next is null. This null keyword is used to indicate that a reference does not refer to anything. It removes the garbage value. Here the null is not any value, right guys? Null only indicate that the reference does not refer to anything. Package. This package keyword is used to declare a Java package that includes the classes, right class? And the starting of the class, like you have seen that in the start of the class we write the package. So this package is used to declare a Java package that includes the classes. Actually it shows the directory where our Java class is present. Now the next keyword is private. Java private keyword is access modifier. It is an access modifier. Okay, private is an access modifier. It is used to indicate that a method or a variable may be accessed only in a class in which it is declared. Right guys, if any variable is private, then it can be accessed only in that particular class only. Now next is protected. Java protected keyword is an access modifier. This is also an access modifier. It can be accessible within a package or outside the package, but through inheritance only. Like if the variable is protected, then that variable can access, that can be access within a package or outside the package, but through inheritance only. We cannot apply it on the class. We cannot apply the protected keyword on any class, right? Now the next is public. This public keyword is an access modifier. This is also is an access modifier. It is used to indicate that an item is accessible anywhere. It has the widest scope among all the modifiers, right guys? Now the next is return. Java return keyword is used to return from a method when its execution is complete. Like guys, you have seen inside a method in the last line we write return. So this return keyword is used to return from a method, okay, when its execution is completed, or it can return any value, right? Now the next keyword is sort. This sort keyword is used to declare a variable that can hold a 16-bit integer. Sort keyword can hold only a 16-bit integer value only. Now the next is static. Java static keyword is used to indicate that a variable or a method in a class is a class method, right guys? So static keyword is used to indicate that a variable or a method is a class method. The static keyword in a Java is used for memory management mainly, okay guys? And now the next is static strict FP. This strict FP is used to restrict the floating point calculation to ensure the probability, right? The next is super. Java super keyword is a reference variable that is used to refer parent's class object. It can use to invoke immediately parent class method, right? So again, a super keyword is a reference variable, right? It is a reference variable that is used to refer a parent class object. It can use to invoke immediate parent class method only. So now the switch. The Java switch keyword contains a switch statement that execute code based on the test value. The switch statement tests the equality of a variable against the multiple values, right? Now the synchronized. Java synchronized keyword is used to specify the critical section or a method in a multi-threaded code. Now next, in the next slide, we are going to see the keyword as this. Java this keyword can be used to refer the current object in a method or a constructor. This is used for a current object, okay? Now the next is throw. The Java throw keyword is used to explicitly throw an exception. The throw keyword is mainly used to throw the custom exception. It is followed by an instance. Now the next is throws. The Java throws keyword is used to declare an exception. The Java throws keyword is used to declare an exception. Checked exception can be propagated with the throws. Now the next keyword is transient. The Java transient keyword is used in a serialization. If you define any data member as a transient, it will not be serialized, right? If we define any data member as a transient, then it cannot be serialized. Now the next keyword is try. Java try keyword is used to start a block of a code that will be tested for exception. The try block must be followed by either a catch or a finally block, right? Now the next keyword is void. Java void keyword is used to specify that a method does not have any return value, right guys? Java void keyword is used to specify that a method does not have any return value. Now the next is the volatile. Java volatile keyword is used to indicate that a variable may change asynchronously, right? Now the next keyword is while. Java while keyword is used to start a while loop. This loop iterates a part of program several times If the number of the iteration is not fixed, it is recommended to use while loop. So guys, where we can use while loop? We can use while loop in that case only if the number of the iteration is not fixed, right? If the number of iteration is fixed, then we will go with the for loop. And if the number of iteration is not fixed, then we will go with the while loop. So guys, these are all the keywords we are using in Java programming. Okay guys, so these are the list of the keywords, and I have explained all the keywords in a brief. Okay guys, so that's all for the tutorial on keywords in Java. In the next tutorial, we are going to discuss about the identifiers in a Java programming in depth. So again guys, I will ask you to subscribe the channel if you have not subscribed the channel. Okay guys, to get notified whenever a next tutorial is uploaded in this channel. So guys, thank you and happy learning, and take care guys.